Who was that?
I don't know, Tommy.
Oh, you don't know?
I'm young. I don't know.
Oh, you are young? You don't know? Okay. How come you know about the Bible? You don't know about
the Bible? No,
he's trying to learn it. You explain, no? You are old man, explain, no?
So, explain. Have you heard about Zahid?
Yes.
Zahid?
Yes, Zahid.
Yeah?
Maybe.
Have you heard about Zainab?
Zainab, yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
Zainab was the wife of Zahid.
Right. Okay.
Yeah? Yeah? So, Zahid was Muhammad's adopted son. Yeah? Yeah. Muhammad's adopted son.
Anyway, I'm coming next week. Are you here next week? Oh,
every Sunday.
Okay, good. I'll
see
you next week.
No, why you are going?
I'm not running.
Come on.
I am not running.
Come on.
I told you.
Come on, let's talk. Let's talk. Let's talk. No. Come. No. That's unfair.
That's unfair. I told you before.
Are you Muslim or Christian?
I'm a Muslim.
You are Muslim?
Of course, because I'm a Christian.
Okay. Who was the father of Muhammad?
The father of Muhammad. Okay, he died, didn't he? Okay, Muslim.
Hello. How are you?
Huh?
Abdullah.
Okay.
Yeah?
Okay.
What does Abdullah mean?
You tell me.
Slave of Allah.
Okay.
Yeah? Am I right?
No.
Slave of Allah. So Abdullah was the slave of Allah.
Abdul means like man.
Yes, man.
Man
of Allah.
Okay.
Or slave of Allah.
Okay.
Yeah? So Abdullah was born in pagan family. He lived as a pagan. He worshipped pagan Allah. He died as a pagan. So which Allah servant he was? Which Allah servant he was?
He was Allah servant, like
you said. Huh? You said,
yes.
You said Abdullah mean the servant of Allah or the man of Allah.
Yes.
But Abdullah was born in pagan family.
Right.
He lived as a pagan.
Right.
He worshipped pagan Allah.
Right.
He died as a pagan. So which Allah servant he was?
Okay. So
does this make sense? Does this make sense?
So his name is Abdullah.
Yeah.
And then he worshipped pagan.
Of course. So same Allah.
Yes.
Same Allah is in Islam. That same pagan Allah is in Islam now. So Islam is worshipping a pagan Allah. Pagan Allah, not true God. True God is God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. That is true God. Not Allah.
And who is that God?
Huh?
Who is that God?
Who is that God?
Is it Jesus?
I am. That God is I am.
Is that Jesus?
Huh?
And is that Jesus?
Is that Jesus? It is Jesus.
And Jesus is loving.
Huh?
Yeah, and Jesus is loving, right?
Jesus is loving.
Okay.
All the time.
That's why
he died for you.
Exactly. So
he died for you.
Let me tell you this. Let's bring you back to the point that we made in the beginning.
Yeah.
So Jesus is God.
Yeah.
Jesus is loving.
Yes.
Jesus is just.
Yes.
So Jesus killed.
Yeah.
You know, like I said before.
That's right.
The kids, all this.
Don't you see this judgment here? When people are indulged in homosexuality, don't you think this is a judgment here? This is a judgment. Don't you think this is a just God bringing a judgment? Yeah? So, how can you accuse that Jesus who is bringing the judgment on Sodom and Gomorrah? Yeah? Who is bringing the judgment on Noah's people? Yeah? That's why that God is God Almighty. He is all loving, but he is just as well. Therefore, that God is a just God. That God is a living God. That God is a loving God.
Okay. So you see homosexuality, right? So
yeah.
What do you believe the punishment for it is?
Huh?
What's the punishment for homosexuality?
What is the punishment of sex, homosexuality?
Homosexual. What's the penalty?
Penalty. You have seen it clearly, the penalty on Sodom and Gomorrah.
Yeah, but
the penalty on Sodom and Gomorrah.
Just Sodom and Gomorrah.
Yeah.
All the homosexuals in general.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know, they would, because look, there's a verse in Romans.
Yeah.
Which it says that
yeah.
the same way the man yeah. also abandoned natural relations with a woman.
Yeah.
And inflamed with lust for one another.
Yeah.
Men committed shameful acts with other men.
Yeah.
And received in themselves a due penalty for the error.
Yeah.
That penalty.
Yeah.
Although they know God's righteous decree that those who such things deserve death.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
They do not only continue to do these very things, but also approve of who practices them. So all the people that also support it, right? Even those that support it also die, basically. So saying that.
Say it again. Say it again.
Okay. So you're saying that. So Romans 1:32. Right?
Yeah.
So it says, also, they know God's righteous decree that those who do such things deserve death.
Yeah. Right? Yeah.
They not only continue to do these very things,
yeah,
but also approve of those who practice them.
Yeah. So Noah, Lot and family, they were not indulged in homosexuality. Yeah? That's why God saved them. God protected them.
Right.
Yeah?
Right.
But all other, those who were indulged in that wicked thing, they were destroyed. So that's the punishment God is bringing on those who are indulged in such a bad thing. So God is always just.
Yeah, but do you believe they deserve death?
Huh?
Do you believe they deserve death?
They deserve death.
Do you believe they deserve death?
Of course.
Or do you believe
of
they
course.
Need to be helped?
Of course.
Do you believe you need to help them? Okay.
Noah preached for 120 years. And Noah told them over and over and over and over again that be repented. Don't indulge in idol worship. Yeah? So 120 years is not less warning.
In that verse, it never says that.
But finally, God is going to bring a judgment. That's why this God is telling you that there is going to be a judgment. So repent and be baptized.
Baptized.
Yeah, you need to be baptized. You repent and be baptized. So come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Otherwise, you will be destroyed.
I don't believe in a book which has many contradictions.
There is no contradiction in the Bible.
How did Judas die?
Huh?
How did Judas die?
Which Judas you are talking about?
The Judas that killed himself.
Oh, how he died?
How did he die? Do you know?
He died by hanging himself upside down.
Hanging himself.
Okay. Yeah.
So it says that he hanged himself.
Yeah.
Right.
And so why did he do that?
Pardon?
Why did he do that?
Tell me, you know your Bible.
No, why did he do that?
Pardon?
Why did he do that?
You tell me.
No. You are the one who is bringing this.
Yes, there are two different accounts. So one account says that he hanged himself.
Yeah.
Another account says that his insides gushed out. Right? He fell and his insides gushed out.
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
So, one of them says he died by accident, and the other one says that he died by suicide. Tell me, does suicide and accident work together?
No, think about...
You're speechless.
No.
Okay,
think about there is an accident on this roundabout.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
And several journalists will come there, and they will see that there is an accident.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
But everybody will write in their own way. The theme of the story will be same.
But that means it's not
historical. The theme of the story will be same.
Okay.
But they will be writing in their own ways. Yeah?
Yes.
Some may say there were 50 people gathered. Some will say there were 20 people gathered.
That means it's not historical. Do you believe the Bible is historically accurate?
Yes, it is accurate.
You just told me that they give them
it is accurate. It is accurate according to the story.
But you just
but it is not accurate maybe according to your thinking. according to your thinking, that different people are bringing the same story. So they are writing in their own way.
Sir?
Yeah. So,
like said,
so there is no contradiction in that.
No.
So there is no contradiction in the story.
He fell.
No. There is no...
Say,
okay. Somebody may write that man was running and he was hit by bus. Or somebody may write that man was slipped and fall.
Yeah, like you're saying.
Yeah.
Let me give you the same example.
So the story is same.
Let me give you the same example.
Story is the core of the story is there is the accident.
Let me give you
the
same
core
example.
Of the story is the accident.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let me give you the same example like you said.
Yeah.
Man was running and he's hit by a car. Is that what you said?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So let's say man was running and he's got hit by a car. And then in another account they say that same man hanged himself or committed suicide, jumped off a cliff. Are those things the same?
The story, what is the core of the story?
I mean, to be self-explanatory.
Do you know the core of the story?
You tell me the core of the story.
The core of the story is, yes, this is accident happened.
Suicide is not...
And this accident is happened this way.
Suicide is deliberate. It's not an accident. Suicide, you're doing it.
Of course. He hanged himself. What does this mean?
He committed suicide. He hanged himself.
Yeah.
Okay.
He hanged... This means that he felt sorry what he has done.
Yeah.
Yeah? He felt sorry for what he has done.
Yes. And then
was the wrong he did?
Okay.
What was the wrong he did?
I think he was a traitor to Jesus, I think. I think he betrayed Jesus. Didn't
That's
he?
Right.
Okay. Yeah.
That's right. So he felt sorry in his mind.
So he committed suicide.
Yeah. So he hanged himself.
Makes sense, right?
Yeah.
Okay, but in another account it says that he fell, right? He stumbled or fell.
Oh, see,
what do you want to
say? See the story.
And his inside
story, there is no different in the story. The story says that he died. Yeah?
Okay.
Whether he died hanging himself or he died with an accident or whatever the way.
Okay. No, I get your point.
Yeah.
He died. Right?
He died. The core of the story is this, that he died.
I agree with you. But you believe that the God is God's word, the Bible is God's word from beginning to end.
Yeah.
There must not be any contradiction. Even a small contradiction.
There is no contradiction.
But you just said that.
No. It's not contradiction.
Right.
It is the writer. It is the writer who is writing the story in their own way. There is no contradiction in the story. Like there are four gospel.
According to Mark, according
Matthew, Mark, Luke and John.
According.
Huh?
Remember to use that word, according to Mark. According to
what do you mean by according?
If I make a book about you, do you know yourself more than I know about you?
Do I know?
Sir, do I know about you more than you know about yourself?
No, of course, I know myself.
Of course.
Yeah.
So if I make a book about you, saying, according, what's your name?
Asif.
So if I make a book saying, according to Asif, made by me, a book about you, is it going to be accurate?
If you are writing about me?
Yes, is it going to be accurate?
If you are inspired about me, then you will write everything about me.
Right. But what
but
I mean,
since,
if you write a book about yourself, you are going to write a book about yourself. I will write a book about you.
Yeah.
Which book is going to be more accurate towards you?
Which
yourself,
book?
Isn't it?
Huh?
Okay, so look. I make a book about you.
Yeah.
You make a book about yourself.
Okay.
Okay. Which book that we're going to make is going to be the most accurate?
The one I will make.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good. So, and what the book that I'll make will be according to you.
Maybe the thing which I wanted to explain you, it did not recorded in your memory yet. What I said, the core of the story. the core theme of the story. If the core theme of the story is different, then you can say that there is a difference in the story.
Okay.
But the core theme of the story is the same in every account.
Right.
In every account. Therefore, the contradiction is not in the stories.
Right. Okay, I'll give you one more, which is like what you said, a different outcome.
But now you will answer me Quran as well.
Okay,
yeah?
If you tell me about the Quran,
yeah,
and then let's say I can't answer you, right? You come here every week, right?
Yeah.
I go home, I do my research, I come back and I'll answer you and we'll see if you agree with me or
not. Right.
Okay, you can ask your question.
Okay. Okay. No, tell me.
Okay.
Quran and Hadith, they unanimously says that Allah is a pagan god. Pagan god.
No, Allah is one.
Allah is a pagan god.
Pagan god. Where does it
pagan,
say?
Pagan.
Yeah, I know what pagan is, but where does it say?
Huh?
Where does it say?
In Quran.
In the Quran?
Yeah.
Okay, tell me where it says that.
Sister, do you remember the verse where it says Allah is a pagan in the Quran? Like Lat, Manat, and Uzzat, they are the...
Yeah, that verse. Okay, yeah, I can ask you.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah.
That doesn't say that he's pagan, by the way. Okay.
Yeah. So.
So right after that verse that you're talking about.
Yeah.
About Manat and.
So.
Right after that verse.
Yeah.
It contradicts you because it says that it's not. If I can summarize the verse that goes after it, is the fact that these are not actual angels or actual gods. These are not real. They were made up by pagans. Right?
Oh, yeah, they were the goddesses of pagan.
Yeah, but they were made up.
No. Listen. Listen.
Okay.
Let me give you the background of this story.
Just tell me the story. We'll find out.
Okay. Yeah, the background of the story is this, that all Quraysh. Who were Quraysh?
Quraysh. Oh yeah, it's like an army. Like
No.
How can I say it?
They were the family of Muhammad. They were the family of Muhammad.
Yeah.
Quraysh were the family of Muhammad. Yeah?
Okay.
They were the idol worshipper. Yeah?
Quraysh.
Yeah. Before Wahi.
People of Mecca,
yeah,
they were
idol worshipper, pagan worshipper. So they were saying that Lat, Manat, and Uzzat, three daughter of Allah, they are interceder.
Can you tell me the surah?
They are interceder.
Can you tell me the surah?
19 and 20. 53 verse 19 and 20.
53 verse 19 to 20. Okay, so it's a Najm. Okay.
Yeah.
Verse 19
and 20.
19 and 20.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, got it. Yeah. Have you considered Latin? I'm a Muslim. I was born Muslim and I've done research. Algeria. Yeah. Okay, so, and Manat, the third one, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so, is male for you and for him the female?
Uh huh.
Okay. That is then
Allah,
an unjust division.
So
okay.
Allah is unhappy. Allah is unhappy. He is saying that you have taken male, you are giving me female.
Okay.
So Allah is getting upset about this.
Okay, let me carry on.
Yeah.
They are not but mere names you have named them.
Uh-huh.
You and your forefathers, for which Allah has sent down no authority. They follow not except assumption and what their souls desire, right?
Mm-hmm.
And there has already come for them their Lord's guidance, which is Muhammad, right? So it's saying that, why are you following these gods?
So what kind of guidance is this? What kind of guidance is this?
Mm-hmm.
When Muhammad and all the Quraysh,
yes,
they worshipped Lat, Manat, and Uzad, yes, and they bow before them.
Yeah,
they bow before them.
That's before.
Huh?
The people made it up. That's what it says.
No.
That's in Tabari. Yeah. And then Umar complains about it, and then Muhammad says, oh, that was the word of Satan. That's very bad.
Yes.
Okay, what?
Yeah.
It's the word of. Wait. It's the word of Satan.
Yes. That's why, further down, when you read the Quran, Gabriel is coming to Muhammad, and Gabriel is telling Muhammad, why did you do that?
Pardon?
Why did you worship idol?
I never worshipped
it. Why? No, not you,
yes.
Muhammad.
Yes.
Gabriel is telling to Muhammad.
Yes. Why did you
worship? Why did you worship
idol?
So
Muhammad was an idol worshipper before he became a
prophet. Yes, he was an idol worshipper when he even accepted as a Muslim.
Yeah. He was, there were 360 gods in Mecca. He destroyed them all. He was worshipping them.
Yeah, he worshipped before and even after. Till now.
Okay.
Till now he is worshipping.
Till
now you are worshipping that Allah.
I haven't done research about this yet, but let's take your account. Let's take what you're saying, which is, let's say it's true, right? Muhammad was an idol worshipper before he became a prophet, right?
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, when Angel Gabriel came to him, he still was a prophet that worshipped one God and preached this message, which is called Islam, which is now the fastest growing religion in the world, right? So what you're saying here, let's say it was true, but Muhammad still became a prophet who believed in one God through, you know, a miracle of the miracle of the Quran, right? So at the end of the day, he still worships one God. At the end of the day, let's just say it was true, right?
Okay. Let me tell you.
Yeah.
Allah has already promised with Muhammad that He will protect you.
Yes.
I will protect you.
Yes.
But what is the point when somebody has already shot him and he has already injured? He is already injured.
He was fighting in wars.
So if Allah is protecting him after getting his injury, what is the point of having Allah? Allah should be protecting Muhammad before getting injury.
Right.
Am I right?
Yeah,
am I right?
If
Muhammad is already worshipping pagan deity, Lat, Manat, and Uzad, and Allah is telling Muhammad that I'm going to protect you, then Allah is a fail. So my friend, Allah is a fail to do that, because Allah has promised Muhammad that He will protect you, but He failed to protect Muhammad.
And was that in Hadith?
Huh?
Was that in Hadith?
Yes, it is in Hadith that Muhammad worshipped Lat, Manat, and Uzad.
Look. If that hadith says that Muhammad got injured, and the Quran says clearly that Allah protected him.
No, injured means, injured means he did what Allah was protecting him.
Right.
Allah promised him that I will protect you from worshipping the idol.
And he didn't worship the idol.
He worshipped idol.
Maybe
and his people also worshipped idol. So Allah, basically Allah was failed to protect Muhammad.
Right, research,
this is the.
I will research that and I'll come back and I'll respond to you.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Now, did that prove that I'm not running away from you?
Excellent.
Very good.
Excellent.
Right, take care, my brother.
Excellent.
Can you summarize it for me?
So this.
What did you discuss? What
I asked this gentleman that Muslims, they worshipped Lat, Manat, and Uzad, the idol of Allah. And they were worshipping this idol before even Muhammad becoming a prophet. They worshipped, Muhammad worshipped 40 years of his, with his family. And he worshipped Lat, Manat, and Uzzat, and other Quraysh, they also worshipped with him. But Allah promised with Muhammad that I will save you from this worshipping idol. But unfortunately, Allah was failed of protecting Muhammad before worshipping idol. So that Allah is not be trusted. That Allah cannot be trusted. That Allah has failed to save Muhammad. Therefore, he is unable to save Muslim. So Muslims, come to Jesus. Jesus is going to save you, not Allah. Allah failed to save Muhammad because he said he will save Muhammad by worshipping Lat, Matat, and Uzzat. But Allah was unable to save Muhammad. Therefore, Allah cannot save you, Muslim. Come to Jesus. Jesus promised you to save you from this sinful life. He is going to save you. May God bless you and may God bring you to his fold. Ameen. I